Hi, and welcome to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to fix Valorant VAN9003 error. I will show you a few possible methods how to fix this error. So stick around till the end of this video, and hopefully you will be able to resolve this Valorant issue. Before we start, please give this video a thumb up if it helped you. And now, let's jump into first method. As first method, you will set Valorant to run in compatibility mode. To do that, right-click on Valorant desktop shortcut and select Properties. Select Compatibility tab and here, check this box next to Run this program in compatibility mode 4. Now click here and in drop-down menu, select Windows 8. To save these settings, click on Apply and then OK. You can also do this. Right-click on Valorant and click on Open File Location. Right-click on Write Client Services File and click on Properties. Click on Compatibility tab. Check Run this program in compatibility mode 4 and select Windows 8. Then click on Apply and OK. If this method didn't help, then continue to next one. And that is to make sure that our Windows are up to date. To check for updates, click on Start and select Settings. On the left side, select Windows Update. Click on Check for Updates button. And if there are any updates, let them to be installed. If it asks you to restart your PC to apply them, go and restart it. And then check, did this fix this Valorant error? If you are still getting VAN9003 error with this message, this build of Vanguard is out of compliance with current system settings. Then we will have to change that setting, which is most likely to be that your secure boot is disabled. To check is it enabled or disabled, click on Start and type system information. Next to secure boot start, check does it say unsupported or on. If it says unsupported, that means that your secure boot is disabled. To enable it, you will have to go into your BIOS settings. To enter BIOS, you have to restart your PC and as soon as it starts to boot up, you need to keep pressing your BIOS key. BIOS key can vary depending on the type of your motherboard. To find your BIOS key, search on internet your motherboard. Or in my case, I will search Acer Predator Helios 500. And I will see that for my laptop, it will be F2 key. To find your motherboard information, you will go into system information. And here you have baseboard manufacturer and baseboard product. Enter these two informations in Google and find out your BIOS key. If you are still unable to find your key, you can see on the screen now most common BIOS keys. So try them one by one until you enter your BIOS. Now, as you see, I am in my BIOS. And don't be surprised if your BIOS is not the same as mine, because BIOS interface are different for every motherboard. As you see, when I enter my BIOS and go under Boot tab, I have Secure Boot option. But this option is grayed out and I can't access it. I need to go to Security tab and select Supervisor Password. Enter something simple and easy to remember. As you see, as soon as I set supervisor password, all these settings down below are now accessible. First, you need to go down here to change TPM state and enable it if it's disabled. Now I will switch to boot tab and as you see, now I can access secure boot option. So select it and set it to enabled. After you are done with all this, you need to save these settings. At the bottom of the screen, you will see Save and Exit option, and the default key for that is F10. So press F10 and let your PC restart. After that, launch your Valorant, and VAN9003 error should be history, so you can now play your favorite game with no problems. If you have MSI motherboard, enabling secure boot will be a little more complicated. And as I don't have MSI motherboard, I will guide you step by step through screenshots. You will enter your BIOS by restarting your PC, and at the boot, keep pressing Del key on your keyboard. When you enter BIOS, first thing you need to do is enable TPM. To do that, click on Settings, go to Security, and click on Trusted Computing. Here, click on Security Device Support, and select Enable. Now you have enabled TPM. Exit BIOS saving these settings. Then on boot, press Del key to enter BIOS again. Now we need to enable Secure Boot. Go to Settings, Advanced, and then to Windows OS Configuration. Click on BIOS UEFI CCM mode and select UEFI. You will see that you now have Secure Boot option. But before you can change it, you need to exit BIOS and save settings. After you restarted and entered BIOS again, click on Settings, Advanced, and Windows OS Configuration. Select Secure Boot and enable it. You will get this message that system is in setup mode, and it needs to be in user mode in order to enable Secure Boot. Click on OK and then on Secure Boot Mode, and set it to Custom. Save the settings, exit BIOS and come back here. Click on Secure Boot and change from Custom to Standard. You will get this prompt to install factory defaults. Click Yes. Another prompt will ask to reset without saving. On this, click No. Now your system mode is User. Select Secure Boot and enable it. You can now exit BIOS saving changes, and Secure Boot is now enabled. This was the method how to enable Secure Boot on MSI motherboard BIOS. For Gigabyte AMD version motherboard, when you enter BIOS, press F2 to enter Advanced mode. Now go to Settings, Miscellaneous, and click on AMD CPU FTPM and select Enabled. Now go to Boot tab, and if you don't see Secure Boot option, click on CCM Support and select Disabled. And now, down here, you will get Secure Boot option. Click on it and select Enable. And here, select OK. Press F10 to save these settings and exit BIOS. For Gigabyte Intel version motherboard, enter BIOS and go to Advanced mode. Select Settings and then Miscellaneous. Select Intel Platform Trust Technology and enable it. Now go to Boot tab, click on Secure Boot, then Secure Boot Enable and select Enabled. Click on Save and Exit, and you are all done. And this would be all for this tutorial. I tried to cover more of you with different type of motherboard. I hope that you managed to fix your Valorant VAN9003 error. If you did, please hit that like button. If you want to buy me a cup of coffee, you can hit thanks button. Subscribe to my channel with the bell on so you don't miss my next video. Until then, stay safe and I see you all.